Good afternoon, sir. What interest you in a pamphlet?
I'm representing the National Front here in Palmerston North.
Oh, that's right, no, just come on.
Did you see that? As soon as I said National Front.
Yep.
No. And that was the lady. No.
But does that not mean that they're aware of what you stand for already?
No, well, it means they have an opinion. But is that opinion correct? Is it accurate?
Well, I mean, what do you think the general opinion people have, or general understanding people have?
Okay, the general understanding is people have this knee-jerk reaction to National Front, and they think, oh, it's skinheads, Nazis, thugs, racists, bigots, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. All those words sort of rolled up together and hurled at people.
Right.
And that's what they think they are.
Is there any truth to that?
No.
White nationalism is an alt-right movement whose supporters believe white people are a race and seek to protect white culture, as well as maintain white political and economic dominance in what they see as white countries. In recent years, the white nationalist movement has been gaining momentum around the world. Incidents in America, like in Charlottesville last year, have demonstrated the rising tide of alt-right sentiment. New Zealand too has a history of white nationalism, the longest running of which is the National Front, a far-right organization who is pro-white and anti-immigration. In recent decades, the party has been led by Colin Ansell, a Holocaust denier who is widely regarded as one of the founding fathers of the New Zealand Nazi movement. Ansell says he renounced Nazism in 1981, but in an interview in 2006, he said, "I admired what Hitler tried to do, but I'm critical of what he did. He came up with a damn good idea and stuffed it up completely." Ansell was preceded by Kyle Chapman, who in an interview in 2004 confessed to firebombing a marae in Southland. The National Front say they have seen increased interest in the organisation since Charlottesville, and new white nationalist organisations have also been created in its wake. This year, youth-orientated organisation The Dominion Movement was founded, who practice martial arts together and sticker and poster around the Wellington region. The National Front have most recently been campaigning under the slogan, "It's okay to be white."
I'm here in Palmerston North to meet with members of the National Front. We're here today to hand out pamphlets as part of their It's Okay to Be White campaign. Recently, they've been visiting towns all over the North Island as part of this movement.
All right, sir. There you go.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir. You've got time for a quick comment?
Sure, why not?
I'm representing the National Front here in Palmerston North today. Have you ever seen this poster before? It says it's okay to be white. Do you know what it means? How does it make you feel?
Interesting.
Would you like to take that and have a
sure,
read?
Sure, why not?
That's the National Front's position on that statement, which is a part of an international campaign to raise awareness of the predicament of white Europeans globally.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I like it.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Cheers, mate.
Good afternoon, sir. See, sometimes you get that. Just, no. It's quite common. Just over where we were just filming just before, and I did the same as what I did with the guy just now, and asked him, "Have you ever seen this?" And he immediately said, "Oh, it reminds me of the little guy with the moustache," and went like this, meaning Adolf Hitler. And I said, "Well, that's very interesting. Would you like to take this and have a read?" And off he went. 2 minutes later, he comes running back. You know, at full speed, "Have you got any more of those?" And I said, "Have I got some more of those for you?" And I slapped a few more in his hand. A few minutes later, we walked past the cafe, and there he is inside there. He handed them out to his friends, and they were all having a conversation about it. So that was a huge win, and it just expressed to me that you can never tell who's going to be responsive.
Do you get upset when people compare your ideals
not
to
anymore
that of the Nazis and
no.
Hitler?
No, I don't get upset. I just think it's just an example of what's occurred with the constant anti-white propaganda since the end of the Second World War. This comes back to the old white guilt thing. Oh, woe is me, we've done all these things. So you don't have to feel this visceral guilt, but because you think we've done all these things in the past, therefore we have to stand aside. And we're saying, well, we don't have to stand aside because, you know, who have we disenfranchised? And have we not also been disenfranchised ourselves?
How have we been disenfranchised?
Well, are you aware of there's the argument always about the Crusades, isn't it?
Right.
The evil white man and went and wiped out and attacked Jerusalem and the Muslims. Well, the Crusades were a reaction against what had been happening for hundreds of years from Islam against Europe.
Right.
So they were a defensive action. the word slave comes from slaving. White people have been slaves far more than they ever did any enslaver.
But the Crusades were half a millennia ago.
That's right. So what has it got to do with that?
But, I mean, there's far more modern examples of how white people have disenfranchised other cultures. I mean, well, you don't have to go back very far to see it happening, even in New Zealand.
Yeah.
I mean, the way that we treated Māori up until only half a century ago was, I guess, by any standard, was kind of deplorable.
Okay. So on that basis, what should we do now?
Well, we should reparate. We should try and fix the damage we've caused, right?
Okay.
That's how I... But how did you,
okay,
you
are we not doing that?
Well, I think that, you know, we do a small amount, like you say...
So how far do you go with reparations?
You try and achieve equality in your society, right?
Okay. The white European people globally are under the hammer.
But, you know, statistically and socioeconomically, white people still are not under the hammer at all. Like, they are by far the most prosperous people, have the best jobs, the best opportunities. Like, how's that under the hammer?
Is that discrimination? Is it the result of discrimination? Well,
I mean, we created the society in which we thrive under. Of course, that is a form of discrimination, because we've literally created a way of keeping it all to ourselves. Like, we hold the keys to the castle.
To our castle. And why shouldn't we? If you build something, like in your house, you know, you're a McDonald. In your house, you're a McDonald supremacist. I can't come into your house and just use the bathroom and go to the kitchen and help myself to what's in the fridge and sit down.
But
you'd say to me, what are you doing?
I don't want to look as far back as the Crusades, but if you just look in the last couple hundred years, we've built our castle on the backs of other people's suffering. Like,
but
that's an undeniable...
That's the thing. But have we built it on the back of other people's suffering?
Even in New Zealand, of course we have. Like,
have we?
We took this country.
Okay. From the Maori people?
Yes, undeniably.
And what were the Maori people doing when we got here?
They were living their lives. Like, you know, like...
I asked Daniel about what the Maori people were doing when we got here. They weren't sitting around the campfire singing Kumbaya. They were a warring nation.
Yeah.
I mean, have white people ever stopped warring? There's never been a time in recent history where white people weren't warring as well.
It's an interesting thing, frame of reference. What do you do? I mean, yes, we've come here, we've built this fantastic society, but now you're saying that because there were some people here before, I don't know how many there were, how many Maoris were there here? A few million? I don't know, a million? Was it even that much? But all of a sudden, because we've taken it from sort of blended with that population that was here before, therefore it's somehow wrong, and we, on that basis, we have to allow everyone else to blend with us.
What is it that we've got? What are you trying to preserve?
We're trying to preserve the cultural balance in New Zealand, which worked. We had a beautiful bicultural arrangement in this country with the white Europeans and the Maori people.
Who's saying that it was a beautiful arrangement? Are the white people saying that? I've never heard Māori people in the history of colonization say they thought it was a beautiful arrangement.
Okay.
The Trump campaign and then presidency has ignited a lot of right-wing rhetoric in America, and you're seeing a growing white nationalist trend in the US.
Yeah.
Do you think that trend is being reflected in New Zealand?
Well, from what I'm told, we're in the midst of a big membership bubble right now in terms of inquiries and interest. Same thing happened, not to the same extent, just prior to the Charlottesville rally in America. But that created a lot of bad, what they call optics, and a lot of people sort of took flight and got a little bit scared and spooked about it then. But interest has certainly peaked up since then, and we're getting an awful lot of inquiries at this point. I don't think it's about supremacy, it's just about looking after your own people. It's about having a sense of your own identity and your own family and your own people and culture and history. And it's we have no desire or intention to exercise some kind of supremacy or dominance over any other racial group. That's just bizarre. And it's just becoming a little bit safer to be part of a right-wing group, a little bit more socially acceptable.
But as you say, you know, the legacy of the party was that there were white supremacists part of it, and they're still there. So have they put away their white supremacist values, or, you know, do they not bring it up as often anymore? Is the tone of the party changed?
The tone of the party is changing. So, well, as far as I'm concerned, anyway, because I certainly don't buy into that sort of thing. Like I say, I've only been part of it for 2 years, and there may well be people who are under this. It's a broad umbrella. What I'm saying is that the organisation is an organic process, is moving more mainstream. We're picking up a lot more people, and as they become more popular, more numerous within the group, those hard right, what you call white supremacist ideologies and views, are sort of naturally becoming less stressed.